How did we get here to the sanctuary? You got a phone call, actually.
Yeah, it's crazy how we got here. I got a call from a friend of mine. He calls me and he says, hey, I got this church in OC that's looking for someone that does what you do. Music director, worship director type of guy. Are you interested? And I actually told him no.
He said, no, thank you.
I said, I'm not. You know, this was in 2020 during the pandemic, the shutdown, and a little bit of history. You know, we've been at several different churches. We moved all over the states of, I mean, between the two of us, there's six states, right? New York, Ohio, Indiana, Florida, Missouri, California, so many different places. And, you know, we moved around for ministries and for churches. And, you know, for so many years, we just felt used. It got to the point where we were just being tossed around. I mean, my number.
And I was referred to as the you get one free.
Yeah, people say, hey, if you buy Pierre, you'll get his wife free because she sings too. And so that was many years of that was our identity. You know, we were a product of the church system. And so unlike so many other people and their stories, our story is a little bit different because the church system made us. And this is honestly like in a bad way because I felt like a tool for so many years. You know, I would get moved around. We would live here for 12 months and get moved to another place for 12 months to help all these different churches and different campuses. And so by the time 2020 came and we got another call from another church, it was just like, you know what? I'm done. You know, our marriage was failing that year. We just had a baby premature. You was in a hospital. I was in other countries. And it was just a mess. Our home was just
tough.
A mess. I mean, we didn't like each other.
We didn't.
And it got to the point where it's just like, you know what? No, I don't want to work for these churches anymore. And when I got the call to come to Sanctuary, I remember Pastor Jay calling me and I told my friend, I said, you know what? Yeah, go ahead and give this guy my number. We'll talk, you know, we'll talk business, right?
This guy.
So, yeah, so Pastor Jay calls me and I tell him everything. I spill the beans. I'm like, you know what? Churches have just used me, you know, passed me around like a prostitute. They just passed my number around. They say, if you buy Pierre, you'll get his wife free.
I was like, you told him all of that? He's never going to want to work with us.
And I was like, man, we're going through stuff in our marriage right now. I'm going through a deconstruction. I'm trying to figure out what do I even believe as a church. And Pastor Jay was like, yeah, he's like, that's cool. He said, still love to have you. And I remember thinking,
what?
Huh. A pastor is not turned off by this. So many other churches and pastors would just feel like, man, this guy's a liability.
He's a mess.
He's a mess. We don't want to mess with this guy. We don't want to have him on our stage. And Pastor Jay was just like, I still would love to have you come out. Let's just take it one day at a time. And that stuck with me.
Yeah.
And I remember that week I said, you know what? We'll go and sit. And I came actually by myself and sat in one of the rehearsals during the pre-recording days, right, in 2020. Mm-hmm. And I remember sitting there thinking, looking at the team and saying, man, they need a lot of help. And I felt like, you know what? I'm going to help them out for this season one day at a time. And I said, every single day, we'll just go one day at a time. And the doors opened up. And you and I, we were fighting and arguing every single day.
I mean, it was really hard. There were moments where we just really questioned. We were 10 years into marriage. And we just questioned, like, did we make a wrong decision?
Yeah, I mean, we question our marriage. I mean, so many times you'd say, did you marry the right person? And honestly, this was a result of what the church has done to us.
Yeah.
And we blame the church for so many things for our marriage, why it was falling apart. Because in 2020, when we needed pastors, when we needed churches, when we needed communities, they all dumped us because Pierre couldn't be their main guy. And that did something to our marriage. I mean, we had to go through therapy. So when we started and the doors opened up again, after or during the COVID season, I was up here on this platform right here leading worship and we weren't good. I was still questioning my faith. I didn't even know what I believed. And people come to me and say, man, worship is fire. Worship was great. Worship was this. Praise God. And I'm just like, yeah, it was. And we'd go home that night and argue and fight. And we'd go to therapy that night or the night after or the night before we'd be in therapy and just struggling. I mean, there'd be Thursdays and Sundays where I'd get off the stage here, lead worship, and we wouldn't even sit next to each other.
Yeah.
We wouldn't talk for 2 days.
I remember when we told Pastor Jay that we were in therapy, and he was like, good. He said, you'll have a great testimony in a year. And I just looked at him and I thought, I don't know that we will. I literally couldn't see past that year. Like, I couldn't see past that season of us just, like, not getting along and not being on the same page. And, you know, anyone who's been in a marriage, like, you know how draining that is. We had a newborn all through this time. We'd do therapy, and those nights would last, you know, the therapies you just dig, and it's work, and it's hard work, but it is what changed our marriage for us. And between God and therapy. And but when Pastor Jay wasn't fazed by us saying we're in therapy, all the other churches that we've been a part of, they would have set us down. They would have not allowed us to serve. But here at the sanctuary, it's different. Like, you serve and God continues to work on your heart and you get changed as you serve. And so that's when I got plugged in with children's. I started doing the worship team for the kids ministry here, and I'd never done that before.
And even that was hard for you because for so many years, you know,
I was just next to you.
You kind of just lived in my shadow.
Yeah.
You know, all the churches just wanted me and you just sat there and was in my shadow. And I remember us thinking like, we don't want that no more. We want to go to a church that wants us for who we are and for us to find our gifts naturally. And so it was months and months of just us finding out, okay, where do we fit? Where do we belong? Even you getting plugged into children's, you've never done that before. That was brand new. And for so many months, you know, people would watch us lead worship here on this platform. But so many months before that, you just sat in the back somewhere because you were trying to find your place. And knowing that we found a church where we can go through this process of just going through this deconstruction of our faith and what we believe, God did something for us here at the sanctuary. I've never experienced something that I've experienced here before. We've been to so many churches, you name it, size, congregation, I mean, black,
locations,
white, Hispanics,
all of it.
You name it. We've been bought by pastors. They've tried to impress us by
private jets
and all this stuff. And to come here at the sanctuary where people actually love you and care for you, and when someone asks you here at the church, hey, how are you? They really mean that.
Yeah.
And knowing that finally I found a church where I can say, you know what? I'm not doing too good right now. And to know that people will not sign me off.
So true.
We've never been at a church before. There's been times where we had to go to churches where we couldn't say how we really were because people would be turned off by that.
Yeah.
And to be at a church and say, you know what? We're not really doing good right now. We're in therapy right now. We're fighting all the time. The kids aren't sleeping. We're having a hard time. You're having identity issues. And honestly, to encourage someone that's listening to this right now, I just want to say go through the process because I would love to say that there was the one moment where it just clicked and it sparked and someone just changed everything. And it wasn't. I remember December of 2020, we were singing this song, say, God, turn it around.
Mm.
And we sang that song for weeks. I remember going on long walks, crying that song. God, will you turn it around, turn it around. And I'd get on this platform. You'd go back to the kids, lead worship. And we'd be praying, God, turn it around, turn it around. We'd have some hard times.
Yeah.
And I remember one day feeling a little bit better. The next day, the next week, the next month. And one day, we're just sitting here thinking like, whoa, God turned things around.
Yeah.
And it was just this process of just being consistent, being faithful, not lying to ourselves.
It wasn't like an overnight thing. It was, you know, it would feel a little better and then it would go back and it'd feel rough again. And then it'd feel better for 2 or 3 weeks and it'd go back. It was just this constant healing process of like working through those things. And it really did make a difference when God gave us a church that allowed us to be in that space to just heal. And there has been so much healing that's happened for us here at the sanctuary, just how Pastor Jay and Pastor Christy and everyone here has just loved us openly and like didn't judge us because we were going through things or
It was,
they gave us that space.
Yeah, it was a game changer. And honestly, now it's wild. You're now plugged in full time with the children's. I'm here. I'm serving with the worship department. It has been a phenomenal experience. Our children are here. They are loved. My son leads worship with the kids. Like, this is home for us. I had someone call me the other day and he said, hey, man, how long are you going to be at the church? And I said, I'm going to be there as long as God allows us to be here.
Jordan asked us that. He said, can we stay here forever?
I'm like, this is
home. And we said, we're here till Jesus says something different.
And that's what it is, man. And so this has been a phenomenal experience. Like, I feel like the best is really yet to come, being here at the sanctuary. There's no other place, honestly, I'd rather be.
No.
And now, like, things are just at a whole nother level. We're plugged in, and so our hearts are full. Our marriage has been restored.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Like, we get rest at night. We get sleep at night. And honestly, we count down the days throughout the week when we're going to be here. I feel like we're here every day.
I think we are now. Now that I have taken the position of children's director, children's pastor, we are here every day.
Single day.
But we have, there's so much growth and so much potential that's coming out of this church. And the children that we have in the back have grown such a big place in my heart. This is our next generation. This is who we're building up to be here for 2,999, the 2999 year. This is our future. And to be able to teach these children the heart of worship and who God is for them and how Jesus loves them, and for us to just be the love of Jesus to them every Sunday and every Thursday, it is the biggest blessing. And I am truly excited for all the amazing things that God's going to do through our kids.
Amen.